to take command of this match.
Root's going up the rope.
He's going to try, Jeff, a high-risk maneuver right here. As he's up.
Roddy Piper appeared on the scene, ravishing Rick Rude couldn't concentrate on his match with the Ultimate Warrior. Let's see what happened.
Roddy Piper caused this whole thing. Rude had this match won.
I don't know if he had it won or not. He certainly had the advantage, and now the advantage is all Ultimate Warriors.
This is horrible. This is an atrocity. I can't believe Morella would allow Piper to come out here and distract the champion.
Never.
Wait a minute, Bobby. Warrior, I told you, you weren't man enough to beat me. What I won, and I proved it to the world. I had you beat. There was no way you could become the champion.
Then what happened? What happened, Bobby?
Where did Piper come from? He was supposed to be at home.
We were jobbed. They planned all this. They stuck it to us. The World Wrestling Federation, the Ultimate Warrior, and you, Rowdy Piper. Well, we're going to stick it back.
You're going to wish you stayed home, Piper. You're going to wish you never came to SummerSlam.
Pay attention to the genius, all you little boys and girls. Back to school means the end of your vacation. You'll get up early every morning like your other stupid friends and pretend to get a decent education. Behold, the world's smartest man, who's earned the name of genius, quite qualified to give you some advice. If you do only what you're told with narrow-minded diligence, you'll join the ranks of laboratory mice. Let the genius be your mentor. Let the genius be your guide. Let the genius be your formal education. You'll never be as smart as me, no matter how you try, because I am the World Wrestling Federation.
I'll be the first one to admit, the million-dollar man, he deserves a pat on the back. He's the one that put Jake the Snake Roberts down, and they said he wouldn't come back. Liars, all of them. DiBiase, one thing about a man like me, when you play with things like this, you gotta learn. A man like me, when you put him down, you gotta put dirt on top of him, my man, or he'll get back up and come back to haunt you. What I'm trying to say is this. You give me yours, now I'm gonna come get mine.
The Intruder! And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, returning as an active wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation after being reinstated by President Jack Honey from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 242 pounds, Rugged Ronnie Garvin!
This guy's disgusting.
outside interfered, caused Valentine to lose that match. Then did you see what he did in SummerSlam?
Well, he was just a surprise ring announcer.
Yeah, a surprise ring announcer. Valentine gets a tremendous victory. And what does Garvin do? Announces his opponent as the winner.
I love it.
Yeah, you would love it, McMahon. You're so biased, sometimes you make me sick.
Thank you.
You would take that as a compliment, too, wouldn't you?
Well, I'll tell you what, Greg the Hammer Valentine is really going to have a match with this man. These two are going to go at it like two bulls. Valentine and Garvin.
Whoa, two big right hands in there.
The intruder to the canvas. And you would think Garvin would be off a little bit on his timing or something, not having wrestled in such a long length of time, Jeff, but I don't see it. He doesn't look rusty at all to me.
Yeah, he's breaking the rules left and right, just like he always used to do. Look at that, scratching. Scratching down the back. That's good scientific wrestling, isn't it? Referee standing there, not doing nothing
to the face.
You know what I think the problem is? Garvin's got Jack Tunney intimidated. That's what it is.
We spoke to Rugged Ronnie Garvin a little bit earlier on.
It's an old fact, Greg Valentine, that you're a tough wrestler in the ring, but you're not a mental giant. You see, the game I've been playing with you, last week I embarrassed you so bad that you can't even go home and sleep right. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, it's going to be the time to get physical.
That's what kind of match they're going to have, all right, is a physical match.
Oh, you can bet on that, because I'll tell you what, Greg the Hammer Valentine backs up from nobody, McMahon, nobody.
That's true as well. Look how red the intruder's body is.
I said it before. I think Garvin has Jack Tunney intimidated.
Well, the question is, does he have Greg the Hammer Valentine intimidated?
Never. Not even with this stomping right here.
The Garvin stomp. And the intruder, I don't believe, will be intruding anymore. This match is over. Oh my goodness.
Well, he didn't get the name Rugged for nothing.
Whoa.
Why don't you just do color, too, while you're at it?
I apologize, Jeff. Go ahead, take it.
Forget it. Let's go to Brother Love.
I wonder if he's going to thank us this week.
He thanks us every week.
Bye.
I'll tell you
particularly. You know, Brother Love, as far as I'm concerned, the whooping that the big boss man's gonna put on Dusty Rhodes, not only did he ask for it, but the fat fool deserved it.
That's right! Dusty Rhodes, the common man, strong for the common people. Well, boys, you walked into the World Wrestling Federation, tried to make a name for yourself by picking on the big boss man, sticking your nose in my business. Well, boys, I'm gonna chop it off. What makes you think in a million years that I'd let you get away with stealing my property, taking advantage of my manager, committing crimes against me? Hadn't anybody ever told you, boy, there's two things that you don't ever do. One's mess with Mother Nature, and the other is stick your nose in a big boss man's business when he's trying to teach somebody a lesson. I'm gonna take care of the man like he should be taken care of. And as far as where he goes, he's going to the hole, solitary confinement. He's gonna pay for the crimes he's committed against me and the Slickster. You can count on it, boy.
Ooh. That's one guy I wouldn't want to go to the hole with, McMahon.
Well, I'll agree with you there. The big boss man and Dusty Rhodes. That's the matchup.
Ultimate Warrior, that Intercontinental Championship belt belongs to the family. I know it and you know it. Seems like you like to make your own rules. Start a match whenever you want, do whatever you want. Well, pal, you know that we can do whatever we want, wherever we want, whether it be in that ring or on that cold, cold floor. And, pal, you're going to choke. Choke like you've never choked before.
The fear in your footsteps was mistaken as thunder. As you snuck from behind under the giant, you could not look me eye to eye. But the warrior said, feed from the magnetism of the Intercontinental Belt. It will help to withstand the pain. As you, Andre the Giant, know, I look above to the gods. And when you fall below the skeletons of the warrior's past, the power of the warriors will become the eighth wonder of the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, have I got a treat for you. This man is America, Dusty Rhodes. Listen to the response for Dusty Rhodes as we hear the music, and look at this man.
Oh, he's got the hand, he's got the handcuffs, he's got the club, and all of that at one time belonged to the big boss man.
And he's got the polka dots.
Oh, I love it. He is to be interrogated in public. Woo! My brand of Americana justice is everywhere in this building. It is Americana justice. You have been tried, you have been sentenced, and I will give out the execution, if you will, Daddy. Look what I got here.
I remember.
He was forcefully, I'm talking about forcefully, interrogating individuals. So, if I catch you in any arena, in any street, in any building, in any back alley, in any bar, in any dance hall, interrogating American public, I will interrogate you.
I gonna be much of a man, baby? Woo! Yeah!
Was it anyway? What brought me back? I mean, was it modern medicine or some type of space age technology? Or maybe some guy with a voodoo thing waved something over my head in the middle of the night? Maybe somebody just chucked my mouth full of pills, man, said, swallow this, you'll be better. No. Maybe it's all the above. Maybe some guy just made a little incision on my neck, jerked the windpipe to the side, and ripped out that flesh and bone that was bothering me so much. No, sir. I've got a bigger problem than that. I've got a million-dollar obsession. And it's you, DiBiase. You're the only one who'll make me feel better.
Ultimate Warrior, there are two things that are going to fit very nice. The Intercontinental Championship belt around his waist.
Wait.
And these hands thrusting around your throat.
Your hands around my neck, Andre the Giant, was nothing more than a hypodermic needle that withdrew the poison of the Warriors. Now, since the recapture of the Intercontinental belt, the juice of the poison is even more dangerous as the Ultimate Warrior becomes the eighth wonder of the world!
Dusty Rhodes sooner or later.
No, I would say it's the other way around.
Yeah.
Dusty Rhodes is going to have to mess with the big boss man.
He already has.
Yeah, he's a thief. You know what law enforcement people do to thieves, McMahon. They interrogate him and put him behind bars.
I hardly think that the boss man in any way represents any law enforcement whatsoever. At least not in this country.
Now I'm gonna hand out the American dream, American justice to you, boss man, with your own little toys. I'm gonna hand out justice to the American way.
What a neck on that guy.
Well,
gotta be 23 inches.
On Alan?
No, on Dusty Rhodes. Slickster giving Bob Allen a little good advice, I think.
Allen off the rope. Boss man sends him down. Good. Yeah, that'll do it right there.
Slickster says, turn on the light. The party is over. So somebody else, somebody at home might not know.
Come on, Allen wide open now.
thing very interesting.
Who plays those horns when he comes out, those bagpipes? If he ain't playing them, who is playing them?
Rowdy Roddy Piper, in the midst of a standing ovation, stepping up onto the set of Brother Love.
What's with the band?
I don't know. I've never seen it before.
Welcome, Brother Rock.
I gotta agree with that. That's real nice there,
Brother Rod. And you know something else, Brother Rod? I mean, Sister Rod. Where Brother Love comes from.
You know you have this huge hair hanging out of your nose.
Just like you, Jesse.
Well, yeah, she have nice hair too. Reminds me of my sister, yes. Just like the dress, kind of like the legs too. But you know, also where I come from,
where does he come from?
We don't go around sticking our noses in other people's business. No, kind of like you did when you stuck your nose in Ravishing Rick Rude's business. Yeah, you see, when you go around doing things like that, you might just get your nose knocked off.
I can't believe Rude blames Roddy Piper for losing the Intercontinental Championship.
Weren't you there? Were you sleeping?
Like,
but they're not ravishing. No. They're not simply ravishing like Rick Rude, you see, because he's a man. A real man. He doesn't go around. What's with the little bag here? Sorry. What's with the purse there, Brother Rod? What's with your little bag? What's that all about?
We're talking hygiene.
No, it's Brother Love, not Gene. Hi, Brother Love. You want to talk about hygiene? You really couldn't talk about hygiene from the looks of you. You know, not shaving too well or anything like that. But, you know, Ravishing Rick Rude knows an awful lot about hygiene. And I also know something else about Rick Rude. See, he's a loving man, and I know that he loves you.
What we're talking here is major bad breath. You know what you need?
Uh-oh.
What you need is you need a lesson in hygiene. Hi, Brother Love.
Uh-oh. Where's he going? What's the purpose of this, McMahon? What is that?
We're talking your basic dental flossing.
Dental flossing? He may catch a disease as a result of that.
Where are the WWF officials when this goes on?
They're probably sitting back enjoying this like I am. I don't know.
Oh, no.
You brush after flossing.
Look at that. Piper's a real tough guy, isn't he?
Oh, me. Brother Love is definitely getting a lesson in hygiene. What's he doing there?
Well, thank goodness at least Heenan's got the guts to come out.
Oh, man, you're not.
what she's saying.
I beat you at your own game, Piper. I put you to shame right there on prime time. So you had to get even. You had to come down when I had the Ultimate Warrior beat and cost me the Intercontinental title. Well, I can imagine you sitting at home with that howdy-doody face just chuckling away. But you got to know that I'm looking for you. You've got to know that I'll find you. And he who laughs last, laughs best.
It's howdy doody time, it's howdy doody.
Aw, what's wrong, Mr. Rixie Rudesy?
Nothing to hold up your pants no more? Why, on prime time, you were such a big shot, huh? If you can't do the time, don't do the crime. You think you're the first one got in my face? Why, next time I see you, it might be full moon.
I mean, you think about it. You turn on your TV set or you look in the newspaper, you don't see no good news. You see killings. You see things happening that shouldn't be happening. You see in cities getting swept away. You see in landslides. You see in earthquakes. You see a lot of stuff that ain't gonna make nobody happy. Well, DiBiase, the million-dollar man that you are, those are just minor problems. Plane crashes mean nothing compared to what you're gonna have to live with. Because for me to say that the next time I see you is not going to be good for you, that's not true. Every time I see you is not going to be good for you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week hails from the upper part of Manhattan in New York City, from the heart of Harlem, one of the most dangerous men of the World Wrestling Federation today. He is Bad News Brown.
He might just nail Mean Gene up there.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Not at all.
Nice to see it, too.
Thumbs down from everyone.
Bad News Brown, it's no secret you have chosen to go it alone in the World Wrestling Federation. You have virtually no friends. Now, I've always contended that no man is an island, but you've proven me and many others wrong.
Let me tell you one thing, Mean Gene, and let me tell these beer belly sharecroppers something. Huh? Bad News Brown does not need any friends. He doesn't need any managers. He doesn't need any assistants. He doesn't need a second to back him up. Because in the streets of Harlem, you learn from a young child up that you don't need no friends, because sooner or later, those so-called friends become your enemies.
Need some dental work.
What about the distinguished president of the World Wrestling Federation, Jack Tunney? You've had a go-around or two with this man.
What do you mean distinguished? The man is nothing but a spineless cockroach. That's all he is. And another thing, let me tell you something about this guy. The only thing he's interested in is riding around in his big Rolls Royce limousine. And the other thing that he's interested in is protecting his so-called champ, that big goof that wears the yellow. Yellow, only chickens wear yellow.
All right, you obviously are referring to the World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan. I'm going to ignore that remark. You know, you're kind of a mystery man, Bad News Brown. I want to know about your family. Wife, kids,
what? Wait. Nobody asks me about my personal life. Who the heck are you, the FBI? Yeah. Let me tell you something. If you ever, ever decide to ask me again about my family, I'll slap you so hard, you'll grow some hair on your head.
Please.
All right. Thank you very much. Last man in the world to talk. He is Bad News Brown. I thank you.
What do you mean you thank me? Let me tell you something. And these beer belly sharecrop or something. I don't care about the time. There's only one thing I'm interested in, and that's getting that title shot or whoever else is around to get into the ring with Bad News Brown, because every man is my enemy.
We are out of time. Thank you.
Let me bring in right now Bobby the Brain Heenan, who will once again be with me here in Studio A. I know you don't like that.
No.
And over in Studio B, in your spot, will be a Hot Rod. He'll be happy over there, I'm sure.
He can be over there.
Yeah, he can definitely be there. And the next time that you bring a guest on this program and either you or that guest lays their hands on anyone, there will be fines, possible suspensions. And, of course, the same applies to Hot Rod over in Studio B. Should he decide to lay his hands on anyone, there will be fines and suspensions as well for him. I don't like the idea of being watchdog for you.
Oh, let me tell you something. You don't like the idea. I don't like to be pointed at. I don't like to be dictated to by the World Wrestling Federation. I don't like to be told when I can go someplace, who I can sit with, when I have to sit, when I have to raise my hand to ask permission for something.
Why did you agree to these rules then?
Why did I agree? It's the only way I can get out here and speak what I have to say. Rowdy Roddy Piper walks to the ring in SummerSlam, causes Ravishing Rick Rude to lose the Intercontinental.
He did not.
He did too. I was there. I was right there.
It was only a half truth.
No money came out of your pocket. It's coming out of ours.
Did he touch anybody? No.
Did he touch you? I don't have to answer anything to you.
Did he touch Rude? No.
He was there. He was there, and you saw what he did.
I'll tell you where he is right now. Studio B, let's go to Studio B.
I'm not done talking.
Yes, you are. Roddy, you're there.
Hello. How's your bad breath?
You're spraying.
He didn't used to sleep here, they say. His cushions, Taiwan.
Did you have a room with Barney Frank?
Beat it. Cushions by Taiwan. This is a horror. You know, Heenan, the more I listen to you, the more you sound like Truman Capote. You know that? You got more complaints from other things. I didn't do a doggone thing. Excuse me, I'm going to sit in the fine vinyl I got over here with the oinkettes. Of course, I like my ladies fairly large. I like them fairly small. Takes a man to take them all, you know. Beat it. I'm going to sit down here and listen to you, because if you think... Just a second. Do you still have a champion, Boobsy? Yoo-hoo, Boobsy.
You expect me to sit here and constantly take this abuse?
No, you can leave if you like.
Why don't you both gang up against me? Why don't you just blindfold me and walk across the interstate? You like that, wouldn't
you? That's
an idea. But no, I have too much character. I'm too much of a man for you guys to run me off.
This is going to be great. Boobsy, prime time is going to be terrific.
What makes you think he's going to stay over there?
What license? What are you talking about?
Does Piper have a license to be at ringside, to walk to ringside whenever he feels like it?
Just
people's matches?
Took a stroll. Let's go over to Studio B. I hear some strange sounds. Roddy, all right over there?
Snakes! I see snakes!
You thought I
You could catch something over there, you know.
I know. You thought I was doing Jim Baker, didn't you?
That was Bobby Heenan after Mr. Radishing Rude lost the belt in the Meadowlands. That's what I was doing, Jim. You just seen that? He had big tears.
First of all, let's get serious for a second. You know, I want to give my condolences to Bobby for the relatives that have beached on the West Coast, those two mammals. You know, they were sitting down there, and big tears are coming out, and he blames on me. Let me tell you something, Bubba. If me walking out is going to make your champion lose the Intercontinental title, what's he going to do when he gets in the ring with me, huh, Boobs?
Oh, I'll tell you exactly what he's going to do when he gets in the ring with you.
You tell me exactly what he's going to do when he gets in the ring with me.
I'm waiting.
If you have any loved ones, Piper, if you have anybody you plan on seeing over the holidays coming up, or anybody you plan on maybe having anything to do it all right now. Don't think so. The big boss man's a very big man. Dusty Rhodes is just an average working stiff.
Yeah.
He's American. He delivers pizzas. He works out in
something wrong with that,
gas
right?
stations. He's just a slob. Just a common working stiff.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense
just
to
like
do
Piper,
that. Right?
Just like Piper. The common working imbecile.
Speaking of stiffs, I've been trying to rearrange it.
What'd you find there, Rod?
The brain.
Oh. Hey, that's mine.
Bobby the Brain, the world's greatest manager.
You can throw that away. No, that's mine.
I don't know. Did you ask Rude about this? Huh? Whether he's worth it? Oh, we'll throw this one in the
that
garbage here.
To me.
Boobs,
just,
you just
throw
this
it away,
one.
Rod.
It's
history. You're not being playing favorites.
I didn't see what he had. What did
you say? What's this for?
That was my handcrafted centerpiece I have for my desk.
Hey, Boobs,
here.
Boobs, yo, over here in B. What is this for? Handcuffs for the hot tub in Beverly Hills? What
I'm
is
not
this
discussing
for?
Anything with you. I don't have any kind of a conversation with you.
You can tell a lot by a man about his home, you know that?
Hey, Piper.
Yeah.
Remember when Andre came up behind the Warrior?
Yeah,
please,
I remember when
Andre.
You better get some rear view mirrors, pal.
You want to just relax now?
Whoa. No, I don't.
There's a man with a new song better. Here in the World Wrestling Federation. He's coming up next.
Off your feet, put your hands together, and you're the bird with me. Come on, everybody. Yeah. Everybody get up. Everybody get down. Get rid of such a stuff because the bird man's in town. All right. Come on, y'all. Get on up, y'all. Let's go now.
Cardinal mistake, Brain. Cardinal.
That's where the fun ends, huh? That's where the fun ends, Boobs. That's where we can take this and chuck this away, because I can stand some serious funk. Throw away the hat. We throw away here your manhood that you kept around to make yourself feel like such a man as you hide behind Rude. As you set me up, oh yeah, you see, I'm not one of them guys that's gonna say, oh gee whiz, I mean, he set me up and they beat me up and I was down and I was crying. Yeah, they did beat me up. Yes, you did set me up. Yes, you were smarter than I was. Yes, you took me out there and baited me while I had this buffoon Brother Love who I thought was my foe, and we're gonna have a little fun here because he calls me Sister Piper and he wants me to show my wares. Baby, I've been having wares long time before I ever heard of Blubber Love. I owned his show. Oh, yes, I was set up, but I ain't never forgot nothing. You see, when I retired, I was the youngest man ever, 29 years old. I retired because I wanted to. I'm coming back because I want to. I'm coming back because this gentleman that you had saw very carefully sneak up behind me. Oh, laugh. Have yourself, ouch. Laugh. Have yourself a good time with it. because it's the last good time you're going
Needless to say, a hot rod upset, and rightfully so.
Upset.
Yes, you are.
So, Roddy Piper, you thought you were going to go out on a Brother Love show and teach the whole world about personal hygiene. But you made a mistake. You didn't scope out the situation. And I told you, Piper, he who laughs best. Well, let's talk about the party then, Rod, huh? You think you're the first guy ever hit me in the face, huh? You think you're the first guy ever put mouthwash in my eyes? You're right. And you'll be the last. You want to party? You want to have some fun? Everybody pays the piper. And you go learn one thing, Bubba. You don't throw rocks at a guy who's got a machine gun.
Take you back to SummerSlam, and we'll see Rugged Ronnie Garvin as the guest surprise ring announcer introducing Mr. Valentine.
He claims he weighs 249 pounds. To me, he looks like he's overweight by 30 pounds.
How dare him do that as an announcer?
This individual who can't take for himself, and when he goes to his wimpy manager for advice, little Jimmy can't give him any. He is the only wrestler I've ever seen with two left feet.
Well, he's talking
Where's
a lot.
The room with cheap rhinestones?
Oh, boy, he's really
Can't tell if he's coming or going.
Listen to this.
Made the biggest mistake of his life when he asked for me to be reinstated. Greg the Hammer Valentine.
You go from one extreme to the other.
Brothers and sisters, my guest is Wayne Jake the Snake Roberts.
What's he doing back? Yeah. He said he was going to make it back after the neck surgery. And here he comes.
A jukebox, my man. Somebody sticks money in you and you will sing all night long. But you know something? Damien could unplug you. Damien could unplug you.
But you know something that you could do for me, Brother Snake? You could clear something up for me. Yes, because there have been a lot of rumors going around that you are planning on returning here in the WWF. Yes, why after your surgery, why after laying on that surgery table and having that doctor reach in there and rip that disc right out of your neck? I mean, what's going through your mind? Are you out of your mind? Are you crazy? Are you insane?
Sir, we are obsessed. Damien and I both are obsessed right now. And I'll tell you something about an obsession. It's a very dangerous thing for any man to have a part of. Because you see, with an obsession, I will risk my life. I will risk permanent injury. I will risk imprisonment, my man. I will put it all on the line to fulfill it. If it means ruining the opinions of others, then I will do that. If it means these people that care for me, them hating me, then I will do that. Because you see, an obsession must be fulfilled for me to become a full man again. It is true. I am at the nexus of such an evil endeavor that it goes beyond all sane reasoning. But you know something, brother love? Even without that disc in my neck, we still have the DDT.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Yes. Correction, Brother Snake. You had the DDT. Yes. Perhaps when you were 100%, you had the DDT. But you are no longer 100%. No, no, you are not. And not being 100%, how effective will the DDT be? Can you even apply the DDT?
I guess I could show you. I guess I could show you. But I'll tell you something, brother love. If I've only got one DDT left in this poor, helpless body, the one with the numb fingers, the one with the stiff neck, the one with the weakness in the arm, then let me save that DDT for Ted DiBiase, the million-dollar man. And then, you can ask Mr. DiBiase and get him to testify to the fact that when he put his hands on the snake, there's still a man right here.
Intercontinental Champion. And I'm curious,
fans love that.
After SummerSlam, how high is your blood pressure?
Don't you concern yourself with my health. If you're concerned about somebody's health, you better concern yourself with the Ultimate Warriors. And I'm going to make this simple, because I'm not going to get upset.
He is
I'm
upset.
I'm not going to get a heart attack.
Justifiably going over to
to Sherry, who's interjecting herself in the match.
Justifiably? What are you talking about, McMahon?
Savage has the purse. Savage has the purse. Savage coming in from behind.
Justifiably abusing a woman.
All right. Savage just unloaded on Duggan.
Yay, Macho Man.
And Duggan is out cold. Duggan has not moved a muscle. He's out cold.
Being assisted, and the medical attention is on its way. Anytime a man, Jesse, is out for this length of time, there's no telling what kind of damage has been done.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Hacksaw Jim Duggan's hurt. Here come the paramedics right now. But in my opinion, McMahon, he got just what he deserved.
He what?
Exactly.
What do you mean?
Hey, if you're going to abuse women, you should have to pay the price for it. I don't advocate abusing women. And you saw this guy grab Sensational Sherry right by the hair. And if I'd have been in the Macho Man's shoes, I'd have did it to him, too.
Well, you must have been watching a different match than I was watching. You don't think he had any justification for doing what he did?
You justify any justification in abusing a woman?
Look. You tell me what sort of justification Savage had for going up to the top rope after Duggan was totally unconscious and repeatedly striking him with the elbow. What kind of a justification did he have for that?
Hey, so he was a little overzealous. What the heck?
Overzealous? And a hush falling over this crowd. A lot of applause now.
And there goes the former king. We got a new king. The Macho Man and his queen, Sherry.
Quarterback in the match.
the Brother Love Show. And here's Rick Rude.
Feast your eyes, lady. The hair's combed, the teeth are flossed, and the body is finely tuned. But don't let these beautiful looks fool you. Just ask Roddy Piper how deadly I can be.
Piper! All over Duffy! And it's over, just like that!
Here is over the ring.
Duffy running from the ring. Roddy Piper
out of business. I'm not impressed, McMahon. He used his belt.
I'm impressed. He's rowdier than he's ever been. I wouldn't want to be in Rick Rude's shoes.
He's nasty. This is a mean, rowdy Roddy Piper. And why not?
Piper, something else again. He is back better than ever.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guests this week are the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. They are Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. They are the Brainbusters.
And they're very cocky.
Their manager,
and they're very
Bobby
good.
The Brain Heenan.
Can't argue with that, Gorilla.
Bobby Heenan, in front of this packed house this week, I want you to know that I believe that your men are definitely avoiding, ducking or swerving, the number one contenders of the World Wrestling Federation for these titles, Demolition.
You mean you're talking about the class of the World Wrestling Federation, the two gentlemen that won these titles fair and square?
Oh,
wait a minute, I've got some videotape footage from last week's Superstars of Wrestling that definitely tells it all. I want to show that.
You don't show any bit of film without my permission, pal.
Oh, wait a minute. Roll this footage. Take a look.
Oh, come on.
And look at Heenan tying up the referee.
Oh, no.
I love it. Ref don't see nothing. All he sees is an opponent flat on his back and Arn Anderson on top.
Wait a minute. That's Demolition's music playing. The celebration is cut short. Here comes back. Here comes back.
Now, what business do they have coming out here?
What business do they have? The
exactly.
Tag Team Championship was stolen from Demolition. Let's get it on right now. Yeah, come on. Let's have it right now.
The Brainbusters are the type of team, they prepare for their opponents, they do a lot of homework, they're not going to take no spur-of-the-moment match like that, some big play in front of the crowd by Demolition. The Busters are too smart to fall for it.
Demolition this week.
That's called discipline.
Quite clear to me, Tully Blanchard, that you're ducking the Demolition.
What are you doing, Gino? That you can see that Demolition tried coming in after us after we'd already wrestled some tough competition. You don't do that. You don't become the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions by being dumb, buddy.
But if that's the case, Arn Anderson, why don't you put the belts on the line against the Demolition?
I'm going to explain to you and the rest of these spoonheads out here, I want solid side of you and solid side of them. When we came to the WWF, we had the biggest credentials and we had to claw, tooth, and nail to get a title shot. It took us 9 months. Now all we hear is what Demolition wants. What about what we want? We're the champions. We dictate policy. So Demolition, if you want to get in line, if you want a title shot, you did what we did. You climbed that ladder. But the bottom line is, when you get to the top, the head honchos sitting on top of the ladder are the finest team in the history of professional wrestling, the Brainbusters.
You know, Bobby Heenan, it's obvious we're trying to weasel out of the title shot for the Devil.
Watch your language, little man.
Good choice of words, I think.
Very simple.
Yeah, weasel out was good.
Anybody
I like
wants
that.
A title match, and this goes for you, Demolition. Some money, some contracts, and you're going to have to get in line. The end of the line. What are you doing?
Nothing, I thank you very much. Brainbusters and Bobby Heenan. Thank you, gentlemen.
The
following.
There has been a lot of talk in the World Wrestling Federation, namely from Rowdy Piper about Alfred. I guess it's hygiene he's been talking a lot about, and the case of what he claims, he being Rowdy Piper, claims his bad breath on Ravishing Rick Rude. Yes. And he also claims that he probably has the cure for that too. Knock his teeth out, something like that. What do you think? Into the ring, Bobby the Brain Heenan leading Ravishing Rick Rude, and the soft looks on those faces. And I guess it's because this man no longer has the Intercontinental Championship. This man being Ravishing Rick Rude. Rick Rude claims it's Roddy Piper's fault.
Well, if you look at it logically, I suppose you really could blame Roddy Piper.
I could.
Without any shadow of doubt, he definitely caused the downfall of this man, Rick Rude, who has a right to be somewhat angry
with
him.
What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, Springfield sweat hogs.
And some are quite proud of it, I might add.
Keep the noise down.
While it's not everybody, surely, who can have a body like him.
And show the ladies what they really want to see. Hit the music.
Well, the concentration's there with that lady.
Yes, it looks like her mouth is a little dry at the sight of Rick Rude quenching her thirst.
Whoa! Some of the ladies really enjoying Ravishing Rick Rude. Now back to the fact of this man no longer having the Intercontinental title. And you seem to agree that Roddy Piper ended that?
And
well, he was definitely instrumental, I would say, in diverting this man's attention. I'm not taking anything at all away from the Warrior, because I think the Ultimate Warrior is a tremendous wrestler, and he's a great champion. But I do believe that Rick Rude and Bobby the Brain Heenan, they have some valid points in their favor when they complain about Piper.
Roddy Piper is the last man in the world, Alfred, that I would want to get upset. But that certainly has its implications. But a confrontation between Ravishing Rick Rude and Roddy Piper. Wow, what a match that would be. All right, it's Paul Roma in this match against Ravishing Rick Rude. And look at Rude, he is wasting no time. He is a very unhappy man. He dumps him over the top rope right down to the feet of Bobby the Brain Heenan.
He certainly has a different intensity, Tony. Look at Roma, he's been stung into action by that tremendous assault by Rude.
And with a series of drop kicks, Paul Roma trying to take matters into his own hands over the top of the sunset flip. Can he get him down? He moved out of the way. What a great move by Roma. Showing quickness, coming off of the ropes and being dumped again, this time hitting the top rope along the chest. And Ravishing Rick Rude with a great counter move that time on Paul Roma, who apparently was on fire.
And that was quickly showed by both men. Great speed and great ability. What a tremendous slam that was by Rude on Roma. And Roma's really showing signs of effects very, very early in this contest.
Hooking Roma, possibly screaming about Roddy Piper. He has a one-track mind right now, and it's about Roddy Piper. He did not even want to pin the man, even though it appeared that Roma was kicking out. He is thinking about, I almost said Ravishing Rick Rude, Roddy Piper.
He is indeed. He's got Piper on the mind, and he better get that out of his mind at the moment with Paul Roma, although that was a brilliant snap suplex that he performed there on Roma. And Roma, look at him, he's very, very dizzy, he's very giddy, he's got cobwebs in the head. And I would say right now, after that tremendous blow, that Roma could be beaten quite easily by Rick Rude.
Still screaming for Roddy Piper, in a very grim look, so to speak, to Ravishing Rick Rude. A lot of the fans are chanting for Roddy Piper as Rude explodes with a tremendous clothesline. Bobby the Brain Heenan with his approval on the mat.
You know, Tony, you really never know where Piper is. Piper could be close at hand any moment, and I'm sure a lot of that has got to do with the attitude that Rude is showing now. He's constantly shouting out, look at this, Piper. Piper might be closer than he thinks.
Piper was always the type of athlete, always has been the type of athlete that's got to walk to a different drum. You never know what he is going to do next.
No. And boy, he'll track you down once he gets on your tail too. I certainly wouldn't like him pursuing me. Roma not faring very well at all here against Rude. And this looks like a desperate attempt to make some sort of a comeback, and it is. It's desperation on the part of Roma.
And ravishing Rick Rude during this match is relentless on Paul Roma, picking him up for a belly-to-back suplex. And ravishing Rick Rude, very confident, rolls over, and he could pin Roma right now, but he is, I guess, fit to be tied as to what has gone on. And he is just trying to make an example of Paul Roma,
which he's doing. And that was excellent execution there on the part of Rick Rude with that perfectly high and well-balanced backward suplex. It was a delayed type suplex. They're the type that hurt you the most. And I believe now that Roma is practically unconscious, right out on his feet. And maybe it won't be long before Tim White, our referee, calls a halt to this particular match.
Screaming, come on, Piper, grabbing the sides of the mouth of Roma, trying to pull him apart. Boy, this man is almost possessed with Roddy Piper.
He is indeed, and Roma's feeling the wrath of that anger and that ire. It's nothing to do with Roma, but Roma should try and concentrate more on this match. He should have done his homework and known what sort of mood Rude was in. He may have been able to take advantage of that.
Listen to him and look at ravishing Rick. I don't think there's any questions. We are at the early formations here, Alfred, of a small war between ravishing Rick Rude and Roddy Piper.
Well, Rude is obsessed, absolutely obsessed. He believes that Piper, probably rightly so, is responsible for his demise as a champion, and he certainly means to take it out on Piper at the first opportunity.
Rude not wanting to pin Roma again. He's getting up.
And Roma positively lethargic now. The Rude awakening here.
Here it comes. Once again, nicely applied. He just beat Paul Roma around the ring until he was ready. He beat Rick Rude. Let's get the word.
Here is your winner, ravishing Rick Rude.
And you know, usually there's a smile on that man's face after a victory. There's no smile on the face right here.
No, he showed dominance all the way through that match. He never gave Roma a chance. He was very, very intense from the moment he came into the ring. There was no hilarity at all about him. That was a business-like performance by Rick Rude. And Roma paid the price.
You know I'm always ready, Bobby. Before I bring down this lady, I want everybody to hold on to their seat. You stand here and relax, because Hollywood eats your heart out. I've got you the greatest-looking lady to the Rude Awakening anybody's ever seen.
Uh-oh.
Bring her on down.
Well, he's had some really good-looking goals. That is a nice pair of legs there. If I may be permitted to say that. What a lovely girl, my word. She is a beautiful girl.
And this girl apparently ready for the Rude Awakening. Oh, my goodness.
Are you ready for the Rude Awakening? Hold
sure
on, sweetheart. I have something for you. Enjoy yourself.
And Rude looks like he's going to enjoy himself, too.
Turn around once. Turn around.
Well, Rude really likes the thought of
this. For you.
She's a lovely girl. She's one of the best we've ever seen in the ring with him, Tony. The little ceremony.
Whoa.
We have another winner.
Well, she doesn't seem to be succumbing.
She didn't go to the mat. She's just standing there.
And that's a sort of a smirk on her face. I've never seen this before, Tony.
Relax. This is ravishing Rick Rude. He's not going to hurt you, Tony.
I guess she is.
Relax.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
I can understand that. 25,000 people here.
Oh, here we go again.
Oh, yeah.
This one is really planted on this lady.
She's not going down, Tony.
Oh, what in the world is going on here?
In fact, look, no, she doesn't like it.
She's walking away. Wiping her mouth. And look at ravishing Rick Rude. The lady just walked, wiped her mouth and walked right out of the ring. Fans love it, and ravishing Rick Rude right now.
Oh, my
beside
word.
Himself.
Oh, he doesn't like that at all. Everything is going wrong for him. And that lovely lady just walked away and left him standing there. Now, that's a dreadful feeling.
And the brain.
On your hands and knees, it'll be too late.
The brain is irate also. Ravishing Rick Rude, look at it. Holding his hand, you can tell that this man doesn't know what to do next.
Well, he doesn't. There was no conquest there for him. He may have beaten Roma quite easily, but he didn't win that girl over. She did not succumb at all.
He's got to think about that, but he's also got to think about one Roddy Piper.
Well, there he is again.
Jake the Snake Roberts, in the fact that he was an intelligent, cunning, devious individual, much like myself. You see, I have all of those qualities. But Jake Roberts, you have totally lost your mind. Have you forgotten so soon the countless hours, days, and weeks that you were in total pain and agony? Have you forgotten so soon, laying flat on your back with your neck in traction, staring at the ceiling, wondering if any of the feeling would ever come back to that arm? And you said it yourself, you're a man obsessed. You know, brother love, when a man is obsessed, he can't see to the left or the right. All he sees is straight ahead. He has tunnel vision. And all you can see, Jake, at the end of that tunnel is how badly, how totally I embarrassed and humiliated you. And now you're going to come back. You're going to step back in the ring with the million-dollar man. Let me ask you something, Jake. When you step back in the ring with me, the man who knows your injury, the man who put that injury there, what do you think I'm going to do? What part of your anatomy do you think I'm going to go after first? So go ahead, Jake. Put those wrestling tights back on and lace up your boots. Walk down to that ring and climb in with the million-dollar man one last time.
One last time, huh? I'm not so sure about that.
I love his laugh, McMahon. Isn't it heartwarming?
See a Coliseum home video of the Honky Tonk Man, who was a little on the disconsolate side after his match with Dusty Rhodes. Here's the way this footage went.
He's asking for his guitar.
He wants to play a hit. He wants a hit.
The guitar! Oh, no!
Jimmy's gonna do it!
Right on the head of the Honky Tonk Man!
Honky Tonk Man, if anybody who'd know the name of that tune, I'd have to say it would be you.
Me and Zilla, we come out to Lisa Marie. I've got a concert to do. A lot of people here to see me sing, so somebody help me find a stage.
Well, I'm a little confused, but not as confused as the Honky Tonk Man appears to be.
Yeah.
He thinks Jimmy Hart and Priscilla Presley, they're a long way from Graceland.
Yeah, now we're coming to the part I've been waiting for, McMahon. The coronation of the new king of the World Wrestling Federation, the Macho Man Randy Savage, who destroyed Duggan.
And now, making their way to the ring, the new king and queen of the World Wrestling Federation, Macho Man Randy Savage, and Sensational.
Indeed, a double coronation, a first for the World Wrestling Federation. Here is Randy Savage, and take a look at Sensational Sherry.
Are they decked out or what, McMahon? Now there's a king and queen the World Wrestling Federation can be proud of.
Really?
Not some snot nose like the former King Duggan. There's class personified right there.
Chair, was it?
And it looks like the genius is gonna reap the coronation, I think.
Sherry looks almost regal, doesn't she? A whole horde of individuals awaiting the presence of the new king and queen of the WWF.
You ever see Sensational Sherry looking any better than me?
As a matter of fact, I remember... No, I don't hear it. No, I haven't. There was this one time in the dressing room, though. There she is now.
What a splendid moment.
I hope you're enjoying it, Jeff.
Chills up and down your spine.
Ladies and gentlemen, the genius!
Entourage. Their heads are bowed in reverence at the very slightest whisper of one name, exalting in his splendor, which is altogether fitting of the people and the land from whence he came. False monarchies are commonplace as kingdoms rise and fall, but I, the genius full of glory and renown, say the Macho Man is everything that everybody everywhere would ever, ever want to wear a crown. I say this king deserves a queen beside him on the throne, and Sherry is the fairest in the land. Nobody else is worthy of this monumental honor and the regal splendor of his royal hand. We witnessed the dethroning of one Jim the Hacksaw Duggan, whose crown and robe are in a state of ravage. I now remove my mortar board and place it near my heart, and thus proclaim you Macho King Randy Savage.
The Macho King,
Randy Savage.
Wow.
And Queen Sherry.
Look at this. Look at that robe.
And it says King on the back.
I wonder if the King is going to share a few words with us.
Wait a minute. The $1 million man has a gift. A gift worthy only of a king. So to you, the newly crowned Macho King Randy Savage, I give you this gift a king should never be without.
this golden scepter. Solid golden scepter.
Let's take a look at, wow. Take a look at that, Jesse. I'm speechless, man. I mean, admit the $1 million man does truly have a heart of gold, doesn't he?
Of the pocketbook of gold, I'm not so sure about the heart. And besides, I thought you said you were speechless.
The new Macho King, Randy Savage, along with the first queen of the World Wrestling Federation, Sensational Sherry, being congratulated by all of his cohorts. This is a touching occasion, McMahon. I can see a few tears welling up in your eye.
As if Savage is sharing his coronation with a capacity crowd.
Ravishing Rick was it not, Tony?
Currently in the ring,
weighing a beautiful young lady
pounds,
right there did not seem excited at all that she was being kissed by the Ravishing One.
Boy, she was lovely.
And his opponent,
and
weighing in at 234 pounds,
Ravishing Rick Red, here's a man who's not thrilled at all himself with Ravishing Rick Red.
Before, Tony, if you fool with the bull, you get the heart.
And this man, looking around at a 1,000 jam-packed here in Springfield at the Civic Center, big smile on his face, what charisma! And what ability in the ring! And the last man, I would want to get back.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to have this guy on your list, or him have you on his list.
People realize that already. Namely, Brother Love, Bobby the Brain, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, look at Barry Horowitz, which is bad mouthing as the champ goes out running. Oh, Horowitz took a sucker punch. He spattered.
What in the world is Horowitz trying to accomplish here? What do you think? What's going through his mind?
He's sick. He's a sick person.
come to the center. How are you? You know, just like I was here and I saw Rick Rude bring you up and give you a big kiss, you know? And you didn't seem to enjoy it. Is there something wrong?
Bad breath.
Bad breath?
For the past few months, he says it's much too soon for you to return to the ring for action with him.
You know, maybe he talked to doctors and maybe he talked to a lot of people, but maybe he should have talked to my psychiatrist, because I'm a little bit different than anybody else. Sure, I've got numbness in my fingers and I've got a weaker left arm and the neck's a little bit stiff when I try to turn it due to the operation. But DiBiase, the stiffness and the numbness and the weakness are nothing compared to the hatred that sits behind these cold eyes, my man. Or the fire that spews ashes out of my brain each and every time I think of you.
Jake Roberts. Jake, I have talked to physicians. I've seen the doctor's report.
Concentrate, Gene.
And it's quite clear to me. That makes me nervous, I gotta tell you. Makes me nervous. It's quite clear to me, Jake Roberts, that you may not be ready to get back to action. It may be too soon.
I tell you what, let DiBiase grab a hold of the snake and let him tell you if I'm ready or not. I'll tell you this. Ted DiBiase, Damien and I are not responsible for bringing you into this lovely world, but we'll damn sure be the ones that take you out.
Wait a minute, Jake Roberts. The Million Dollar Man has said many times he advises you not to return to the ring and go against him.
Gene, the obsession that burns within my heart each and every day can only tell Ted DiBiase one thing.
What's that?
Dial 911.